Welcome to my tutorial covering the basics of oscillators. So, what is an oscillator? An oscillator is something that creates oscillations. Oscillation is just a fancy word for something moving back and forth. If you have a swing moving back and forth, you can say that the swing is oscillating. In the context of electrical engineering, the oscillations that we care about are voltages moving back and forth. For example, here's a sine wave that is oscillating from +1 volt to -1 volt back and forth. An oscillator is a circuit that would generate a repetitive back-and-forth waveform like this. And just so you know, it doesn't necessarily have to be a sine wave. An oscillator can generate a square wave, triangle wave, Mexican wave, whatever. Now, what are oscillators good for? Oscillators are used all the time in electronic designs. Common uses include generating radio waves, tone generators, generating counters to keep track of time, and generating clock signals to control the speed of digital processors, including the computer that you're using right now. So, now that you know that oscillators are awesome, how do you build one? Well, here are some of my favorite beginner circuits. Here's a classic square wave oscillator based on a 555 timer chip. This is every student's first way of generating a square wave up to 1 MHz. There are loads of websites out there that go into the details of how these work, so just Google 555 oscillator if you want more information. After you build it, it's going to look something like this. If I probe pin 3, I can see the square wave output of the oscillator with the voltage oscillating back and forth between 0 volts and 5 volts. Now if I attach an LED and a resistor to the oscillator's output, I get a blinky light. If I attach a lot of LEDs and use a transistor to switch the oscillator's output, I can host my own rave. So you can already see how oscillators are building blocks that can be used as part of bigger designs. Okay, that was a square wave oscillator. Let's take a look at a sine wave oscillator. This is a quadrature oscillator based on an LM324 op-amp. If I probe the output of the oscillator, I can see that I'm getting a sine wave of around 1500 Hz. If I use a capacitor to remove the DC offset of the sine wave and connect it to some earphones, I can hear the 1500 Hz tone. If I replace this fixed resistor with a variable resistor, I can change the frequency of the oscillations, letting me do fun stuff like this. Generally speaking, you can tweak the frequency of any resistor-capacitor-based oscillator by changing the resistor and capacitor values. Whenever you find a webpage showing you how to design an oscillator, they'll usually give you the equations for determining the frequency. Finally, when you start working with digital processors like microcontrollers or x86 CPUs, you're going to run into a thing called a clock oscillator. A clock oscillator is a circuit that generates a square wave that controls how fast the processor runs. The popular hobby of overclocking is basically making the clock oscillator run faster to get more processing performance at the cost of increased power consumption. Most clock oscillator circuits will be based on a high-accuracy quartz crystal and possibly a phase-locked loop frequency multiplier, which allows you to reach crazy high frequencies like 3 GHz. Every digital processor is going to be different, so you'll have to check your processor's datasheet on how to set things up. Okay, that covers the basics of oscillators. Have fun pretending to be R2-D2.